Hi, I'm Bethany. I'm an aquarist here at the Greater Cleveland Aquarium. And today I'm bringing you behind the scenes to see our microculture, where we grow minuscule foods for our jellyfish. These foods start off as a dry powder. These are actually shelled up artemia, which is the same thing as your brine shrimp, if you've heard of those, or even sea monkeys. It's all the same thing. And that powder goes through a decapsulation process to remove the outer shell, and then a grow out process. So this cone is the one I set up this morning with a fresh batch of those cysts. And at the end of today, I'm going to feed them a mixture of fats and vitamins and minerals called SELCO. This one here is the one I set up yesterday, so it's already had one round of SELCO, as you can see labeled on it. It's also going to get a second round of SELCO tonight, and then tomorrow morning it's the one that will get used for that day's feeds. So this one here is today's feeds. If you look really closely, you might even see those little guys swimming around. They are definitely bigger, although it is, of course, hard to see when you are dealing with something measured in microns. But this food, we usually keep an air bubbler in it to help keep the water moving around and the animals suspended. And at the end of the day, I can rinse this out and feed it to the jellyfish. Jellyfish require live food fresh every day, multiple times a day, because they don't have any ability to hunt. They have no eyes, they have very little sensory functions at all, but when they run into a piece of food, they use their nematocysts to catch it and move it up towards their mouth. So live food helps keep it suspended so that they have a greater chance of actually running into it and catching it.